Now, let us talk about amyloidosis. It is priority number 3 in our frequently asked topics in MD exam. Amyloidosis, there's a deposition of amyloid, which is a proteinaceous material. It is not one single disorder. Any disorder can lead to this amyloid deposition. Multiple different etiologies can lead to amyloid deposition. But amyloidosis, why this amyloid protein? How it is different from the regular proteins? Now the current theory says, just like prions, which are abnormal folding in the protein, amyloid is considered to be an abnormal protein folding, is what need to be remembered. Even Alzheimer's, Huntington's, Parkinson's, prion disease, they are also the examples of the disorders which are due to the abnormal protein folding. Whatever it is, if you look at the amyloid by X-ray diffraction, what is the typical proteinaceous structure? Bead pleated sheet configuration is common to any type of amyloid. AL type, AA type, any amyloid ultimately is beta pleated sheet, is what you have to basically remember. Where is amyloid? It is not intracellular. Extracellular deposition is the buzzword which you need to understand. And it deposits very close to the basement membrane. You can see this is the congruent stain of the heart, which is infiltrated with the amyloid. How will a pathologist describe this when he looks at it through microscope? Amorphous eosinophilic appearance is classical feature. If you use a hematoxylin eosin stain, amorphic, not basophilic, eosinophilic is the typical staining pattern. If you do congruent staining, then apple green birefringence under the polarized light is another important clue about amyloid. What are the different forms of amyloidosis is the next important question. We have primary amyloidosis, secondary amyloidosis, and various conditions where amyloidosis is found. Primary amyloidosis is also called immunocytic dyscrasia associated amyloidosis. In this, fundamentally, the immunoglobulin light chains are responsible for the amyloid formation. Primary amyloidosis means you think of some immunoglobulin plasma dyscrasias. That is the most important thing to remember. So it is AL, amyloid light chain protein, which is responsible for primary. Another important thing, commonly asked question exam. In primary amyloidosis, in which viscera do you find amyloid deposition? Primary amyloid will deposit in different viscera and secondary will deposit in different viscera. You need to be very clear when you go to exam. Tissues of the mesodermal origin, heart, muscle, tongue, macroglossia. If you ask the person to extend his tongue, you can see his teeth impressions on the tongue, means tongue is bigger than the what mouth can accommodate. That defines the macroglossia. Tongue, heart, muscle, mesodermal origin tissues. Primary amyloid will basically deposit. I'll come to that. Typically, we have on autopsy a stiff rubbery heart. Heart means primary. Agree? Then the heart tissue is stained with the congruent, which you are able to see, the amyloid deposition. This is that firm and stiff spleen. In case of amyloidosis, what is this spleen called, doctor? Sagospleen. Sagospleen is the name given for this kind of a spleen. In case of the amyloidosis, is what you need to remember. Then these are the enlarged stiff kidneys in case of the renal amyloidosis. Basically, when there is a renal amyloidosis, there is a development of a chronic kidney disease, CKD. Generally, in an end-stage renal disease, you find the size of the kidney shrunken. But what are the few exceptions? Diabetic nephropathy leading to ESRD and CKD. And amyloidosis is another cause where the kidney size is not shrunken, is what you have to remember. This is the typical Congo staining in the renal biopsy in case of amyloidosis. Then, in primary amyloidosis, there can be kidney involvement where the amyloid will deposit in mesangium and interstitial tissue in all these locations. Then, which plasma cell discrasias? Primary amyloidosis, you will remember. Multiple myeloma, Waldenstrom's macroglobulinemia, they are all the associated things. Then, the other name given for the secondary amyloidosis is systemic reactive amyloidosis. There is some chronic inflammatory state going on in the body. And that led to that systemic inflammation has led to the development of amyloid protein. Hence called systemic reactive amyloidosis. What type of amyloid? AA, not AL, is what you see in secondary. AA, there is a precursor protein called serum amyloid associated protein, SAA. From that, AA is basically produced. Any chronic tissue destruction or chronic inflammation will increase the formation of SAA, which is the precursor for AA protein. Where will this amyloid deposit, doctor? Viscera, which have parenchymatous origin. Like the kidney. Kidney is involved rarely in primary, more commonly in secondary amyloidosis. And whenever it involves, the nephrotic syndrome is very common. The liver, adrenals, pancreas, lymph nodes and spleen. We said sagospleen, no, earlier. That is more common in secondary amyloidosis. That is the organs of parenchymatous origin. See, I have shown you this illustration should actually come, kidney and spleen should come in secondary, but they came a little early. Don't be confused. Which organs in primary, which organs in secondary, you need to be very clear. Primary, only three things you remember, doctor. Heart, muscle, tongue. You won't remember in exam hall, it is HMT. So, suddenly instead of HMT, you will be remembering it as Titan. So, it's very difficult. It's not very difficult to remember. So, heart, tongue and muscle. Then, kidney, liver, adrenal, pancreas, lymph nodes, spleen. You don't need to remember all this. Automatically, if you remember those three in primary, remaining are all in secondary only. Now, doctor, in liver, these are the typical amyloid deposits which you need to remember. Then, in spleen, there will be perifollicular involvement. Tapioca-like granules is how the amyloid will deposit. It's called sagospleen. And what inflammatory conditions do you remember when we say secondary amyloidosis? Rheumatoid arthritis, tuberculosis, osteomyelitis, syphilis, leprosy, mycobacterial chronic inflammatory states are the ones which you need to remember. Even Hodgkin's disease, renal cell carcinoma need to be remembered in relation to the non-inflammatory disorders which also can lead to secondary amyloidosis. This is an example of those eosinophilic amorphous amyloid deposited interstitially in the kidney in a patient who is having renal amyloidosis, which is generally the thing seen in secondary amyloidosis. Then there are some miscellaneous scenarios of amyloidosis other than primary secondary. Right, doctor? Primary is AL type, secondary is AA type. Now, Portuguese type of polyneuropathy it is called as. In this, a special type of amyloid called as transthyretin. What is the other name for transthyretin? It is the one which transports both pyroxene and retinol. It is a common transport protein in the serum for both of them called transferritin. It is the one implicated in Portuguese type of polyneuropathy type of amyloid. They have a peripheral nerve deposition. Then Alzheimer's disease, A4 amyloid, which is amyloid beta protein, is the one which deposits. And which chromosome is important, doctor? Down syndrome's chromosome, chromosome number 21, is the one. That's the reason Down syndrome patients also will suffer from presenile dementia. Alzheimer's onset very early part of the life. Chromosome 21, A4 amyloid, and Alzheimer's, you are not going to forget. Then, familial Mediterranean fever. It is an autosomal recessive condition. There will be having episodic fever, and just like in rheumatoid arthritis, you have polyserositis, SLE, and all these conditions. Pleuritis, peritonitis, all itis. So, you have polyserositis just like in SLE, even in familial Mediterranean fever. In this also, there will be amyloidosis, which is similar to secondary amyloidosis. Then, medullary carcinoma of thyroid. You have amyloid deposits within the tumor itself, and here it is the calcitonin which is the precursor for the amyloid. Diabetes mellitus. Lot of time examiner will ask, is it type 1 or type 2? Which type amyloid is implicated? It is the type 2, adult onset insulin resistant diabetes mellitus, where amyloid protein is known to deposit into the islet cells. And that is basically derived from insulin or glucagon in case of diabetes. And it is referred to as amyelin. Amyelin and islet amyloid polypeptide is the other name given for it. Why should amyelin deposition should lead to the type 2 diabetes? Basically, beta cells are expected to release the insulin after sensing hyperglycemia. Right? Beta cells are there, insulin is there within them, but they are not knowing that there is hyperglycemia in this guy because he has eaten food. That amyloid interferes with that glucose sensing ability of the beta cells to release the insulin. That is the problem which occurs in amyelin implicated in the process of type 2 diabetes. Senile amyloidosis in the elderly people. Mainly heart is involved. And what is senile amyloidosis protein is? Just like in Portuguese polyneuropathy, transferritin is implicated. No, that is also implicated in senile cardiac amyloidosis. Those who are undergoing dialysis for a long period of time will develop dialysis related amyloidosis, which is fundamentally beta 2 microglobulin is the one which is implicated in dialysis associated amyloidosis. So this have in the heart muscle, cardiac muscle, senile cardiac amyloidosis where transthyretin protein is implicated. So these are the typical congruent staining of the amyloid deposits within the heart, and this is what the heart with amyloid deposition has ended up in. So that is all the story. Amyloidosis is a small topic, but a perplexing topic. Too many things to remember. Where is AL? Where is AA? Where is beta 2 microglobulin? So those things, if you remember, you are the king of amyloidosis in exam hall. Huh? So that's good, doctor.